Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to my channel. Presenting to you the 2013 Porsche Cayenne S. And in this video, I'm going to show you the complete exterior and interior, as well as show you what this Porsche Cayenne has to offer. So with that, let's begin today's video and hope you enjoy the video of this lovely Porsche Cayenne S. So before we begin the video, let me just show you a 360-degree view of the Porsche Cayenne S. So let me take you around the car. So this is the side view. It looks really muscular and big if you ask me. It's been finished with the optional rims, as you can see. Proportions is really nice as well. Let me show you. It's finished in this lovely metallic silver paintwork. Rims. Let me give you a side look. Overall, it looks really nice, if you ask me. That's the front. This is the side look. It looks really nice. The rear look with the tail lights. Quad exhaust for the 4.8-liter twin turbo V8 Porsche Cayenne S. As you can see from this side. It looks really nice, if you ask me. Give you a sneak peek of the interior. Here is the key fob of the Porsche Cayenne S. As you can see, it has the same profile as the Porsche Panamera. So without further ado, let's go ahead and warm the engine up and listen to the roar of the V8 coming into life. There are welcome lights as you unlock the car. As you may notice, the side mirrors are currently folded in. Upon starting the car, the side mirrors will actually fold out. I'll demonstrate that later. If you press and hold on the unlock button, you'll be able to roll down all four windows in the car simultaneously, as well as open up the sunroof as a vent. And to close all of them back together, just press and hold on the lock button. As simple as that. This Porsche Cayenne S is not equipped with the smart keyless entry, sadly, so you lose out on the indentation on the door handles. As you can see, guys, the lovely interior of the Porsche Cayenne S, inspired by aviation. It just looks stunning to the eye. So, to start the Porsche Cayenne S, you actually have to insert the key fob into the slot right here, twist it once to the right, and then put your foot on the brake, and then just twist it all the way to the right. So, upon starting the car, the steering wheel and the driver's seat will move back to its last recorded position before the engine was turned off the previous time. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and start the car to hear the glory and the rumble of the V8. So just insert the key into the slot right here and then twist it once to the right. The steering wheel will move back to its last recorded position and the seat has already moved back to the front position. So as you can see, the exhaust has been set to the sport setting, so it will be at its loudest mode. So without further ado, let's go ahead and turn on the Porsche Cayenne S and hear the V8 rumble into life. So I have to put my foot on the brake and then just twist it all the way. Really nice startup. So as you can see, this Porsche Cayenne S has been fitted with an electric rack and pinion power steering system. The steering wheel in this Porsche Cayenne S is wrapped in black Nepa leather. It features sport grips at 10 and 2 and this 12 o'clock marker right here on the top of the steering wheel. It has really nice paddle shifters as well. It feels really nice, the steering wheel feels really nice to grip as well. An 8-speed Tip-Tronic automatic transmission can be found in the Porsche Cayenne S in Malaysia. The transmission is controlled via this very nice gear shifter right here. It feels very nice to operate as well. There is manual mode as well right here. You just push the gear lever all the way back and then just push it to the left, and then you can shift manually via the gear lever, or your second alternative is via the paddle shifters on the top two steering wheel spokes. The paddle shifters do feel really nice. They are made out of metal. Front and rear parking sensors along with the reverse camera reactive guidance lines are standard. The reverse camera can only be activated when the car is in reverse. So let's take a look at the exterior now, shall we? Let's turn on the hazards. Lights, front and rear fog lights. Take a look at the engine. Roll down the driver's side window. And continue with the exterior tour. Fitted to the Porsche Cayenne S in Malaysia is a set of Nexon tyres. They measure 275/45 ZR20. The tyres do really handle well on the roads, and the rims do have a really nice detail if you ask me. The rims are actually optional. They look really nice if you ask me. They go really well with the metallic silver paintwork. As you can see, it gets Porsche brake calipers as well inside there, as you can see. The indicators on the sides as well, as you can see, unique to the Cayenne. As for headlights, this Porsche Cayenne S isn't equipped with the full LED adaptive set of headlamps. They don't get adaptive high beam assistance and all that. They are not LED as well, but you get halogen projector headlamps, halogen fog lights as well, but you still get your LED daytime running lights and your LED indicators. Front parking sensors are down there. The front look of the Porsche Cayenne, Porsche badge, proudly presented there. And as you can see, you get this sensor right there because this car is equipped with the optional adaptive cruise control safety suite. So you get the radar right there for the adaptive cruise control. So let me give you a front look of the car. As you can see, the Cayenne S just does look really nice if you ask me. It has very good proportions as well, and it's one of the best SUVs out there, if you ask me. Let's take a look at the engine, shall we? The Porsche Cayenne S is powered by a 4.8-litre turbocharged V8, a direct fuel injection turbocharged V8, producing around 400 horsepower and 500 Nm of torque respectively. All the power is sent to the four wheels via an 8-speed Tip-Tronic automatic transmission. 0 to 100 can be done in around 5.9 seconds, onwards to a top speed of around 260 kilometers per hour. This is the engine bay right here. It looks really nice. All the Porsche lettering right there. Direct fuel injection, 4.8-liter V8. It's 8 cylinders for this engine. The engine is held by the hydraulic strut, which can be really helpful when opening the engine bay. The engine bay feels really light as well. The engine cover feels really light. So let's close it. Moving on to the side. Let me give you another look of the rims. On the side mirrors, it gets puddle lights right there. Body colored door handles right there, as you can see. Let me give you a rear look of the Cayenne S. As you can see, it looks really nice if you ask me. As for the rear tail lights, it gets full LED tail lights. And then it gets LED indicators as well. The rear fog light is right here, but it still gets LED reversing lights. Your quad exhaust tips right there. Porsche lettering, Cayenne S lettering right there. The rear fog light is on this side as well, both sides. This is the quad exhaust pipes, one on this side and another one on this side. Rear parking sensors are right there. Let me give you a rear look. As you can see, it looks just amazing, the Cayenne S. Fuel door. Speaker right here and up here. Bottle holders, storage right here. Mirror controls, window controls. All of the windows in this car are fully automatic in both directions. Power child locks for the rear doors. Puddle light down there. Central locking right here. And your 3% memory setting for the fully powered driver's seat. All the driver's seat controls are located right here, together with your 4-way power lumbar support and your power tie support right here. Cayenne S door sills. And right here is the Porsche Cayenne S electronic parking brake. It is currently engaged. To disengage it, put your foot on the brake and pull the lever out. To engage it, simply push the lever back in. The seats in this car are finished in black Nepa leather. They do feel really nice and comfortable. This car isn't equipped with the Porsche crest on the headrest because there's an extra option, so it isn't equipped with that. But overall, the seats do look really nice if you ask me. They grip you in position, so that's really good if you're going off-road in this car. And on the doors, it's finished in black leather right here and this leather trim right here. And this gloss black finish right here. It looks really nice if you ask me. As you can see from far, the interior looks really nice, inspired by aviation. Oh, one thing worth mentioning is the Porsche floor mats that come as standard. So without further ado, let's rev the car a little bit to hear the V8 coming into life. Quad zone automatic climate control system. These are front controls, and there are a separate set of controls for the rear, which I'll show you later. But back to the front controls. Driver side fan speed, driver side temperature, driver side different modes, and your driver side 3-stage seat heating right here. Passenger side fan speed, passenger side temperature, passenger side different modes, and your passenger side 3-stage seat heating. Right here, you have your maximum air conditioning, rear defrost, front defrost, mono mode button, and your recirculation. Hazard light switch and your electronic central locking button right here. And right here, you have a lid which reveals to an ashtray or storage depending on what you use it for. This part is finished in gloss black, part of the gloss black package. Very nice grab handles to grab when you go off-road. Your air suspension controls are right here. This car is equipped with air suspension, so you can raise or lower the car depending on your preferences. Your suspension settings right here, you can choose between sport, normal and comfort suspension. Your various off-road settings right here for hill, your four-wheel drive and your normal road. Right here you have your sport mode button, your traction control off, and this button will allow you to activate or deactivate the vehicle's automatic start-stop feature. If you have the feature activated, the engine will momentarily shut off if you arrive at a stop such as a traffic light or traffic jam to save the extra bit of petrol that this car is running on. Hill descent control and your rear wiper control. Right here you have two cup holders and a 12-volt socket right there. This car hasn't been equipped with the sport chrono package, so you lose out on the stopwatch right there. Instead you get a speaker. The Porsche Cayenne S does come with a touchscreen head unit with the Bose premium sound system that sounds really good, that I heard earlier on. So let's give it a sound test. I must say, the Porsche Cayenne S does have a really good sound system. The sound system is on point and I have no complaints for the sound system. So the display is actually a touchscreen, so you can control it with your fingers, as you can see. So these are all your shortcut buttons right here for your tuner, media, phone, navigation and your map. Your on-hook off-hook button for the Bluetooth telephone system is right here. Your source, sound settings, information, car settings, option, your back button, seat track, volume and power knob, and your manual tuning knob right here. Your eject button for the CD-DVD player right here. So let's start off with, this is your FM AM menu. Currently we are in your FM AM menu, which is tuner. So you hit media, you will go to your media menu where you can pair up your phone via the Bluetooth function. Under phone, you can pair up your phone to receive calls and all that. Navigation, you have your navigation right here to enter your address, your previous destinations, your point of interest, your routes and all that. Can view the map at one touch. So this is the map. It looks quite nice as well, but it's not the best either. So under sound settings, you'll be able to adjust the bass, mid, treble, your balance and fader, and your loudness settings. Under information, you can go through your traffic messages, your route list, your location and your details on your disc. Under car, you can go through your travel time settings, your distance, consumption, your speed and your compass right here for off-roading. Options as well, your back button to go back, and to go back to your FM AM menu, just hit the tuner to take you all the way back. So it is quite a simple head unit to use, and that's basically it for the infotainment system of the Porsche Cayenne S. Central locking. This car does come with power folding side mirrors. There are no controls on the steering wheel. On the right stock, you have your wiper controls. And below that, you have this stock right here to go through that display right there, the multi-information display. Currently, it's showing your vehicle status, so use it up down to go through the menus and your menu and return front and back. So currently vehicle settings, you can go through your audio, your navigation, your view the map as well, phone settings, trip. Under trip, you can go through your ride time, your distance, consumption and speed, your ACC off, and back to your vehicle status. So hit once out, in, to go through your different settings right there. So under info, You have your warning messages, your service and your level settings. Go back, you hit it back to go back here. Under oil level, you can adjust your oil level information, what's your current oil level and all that. Your speed limit settings, and under vehicle settings, you have your display settings. You can adjust the display, the line, the vehicle menu, lower line, menu scope, and the PCM display, and audio, brightness as well. You have your date and time settings. Your assistance systems, your active safe assist, your lights and visibility. You can adjust your exterior lights, how long they fade out and all that, your interior lights, your ambient lighting, your wipers, your reverse optimization, your locking system, adjust your door locks, your comfort entry, auto memory. Under air conditioning, you can adjust your airflow and all that, your volume, units, language, and reset back to factory settings. And then go all the way back to in-vehicle, and you go back to your vehicle display right there. So on the right stock, you have those controls. On the left stock, you have your indicator controls right here. And below that, you have your cruise control stock. You can program your adaptive cruise control via this stock right here. As you can see, hope you can see the stock. It's right there. The steering wheel in this car is fully powered. You adjust it using this lever right here. You can adjust it downwards, upwards, outwards, and inwards. It's fully powered. Right here, front center armrest with a storage area right there. You have your auxiliary and USB port right there. Manual dimming, rear view mirror. This button turns off the parking sensors. Front reading lights. It's in LED, of course. Interior lights. And your fully powered sunroof is located right here. You can control it via this lever right here. Push it all the way to open it in full. And then to close it, just push it forward. One push. The sunroof can be opened up as a vent as well. And then to close it, just push it down. And you can always close the blinds, should you prefer. Sun visor for the driver's side. Just get a venti mirror and a light. It gets the extendable shade as well. So let's say there's sun on this side, you can actually remove the shade and put it towards this side. And then you have another additional shade right here. Very good for hot weathers in Malaysia. And the driver's side does get the grab handle. Alright, so I guess that's it for the startup. We can turn it off right now. As you can see, the steering wheel moved back to its furthest up position. And let's continue with the rest of the tour. speaker right here, and up here. Bottle holder, storage, panel light right here. Window control. The same piano black trim right here. This part is finished in leather, and right here is in leather as well. The back seats are finished in Nepal leather as well, the black Nepal leather. This feels really nice. And the rear seats are adjustable as well. So this lever controls the seat back. While this bar down here, right here, controls the seat position. Chrome dorsal right there. And right here, you have a ashtray or storage depending on what you use it for. I did set the driver's seat to a position that I would feel comfortable in. I'm about 5'7", which is around 170 centimeters tall. There is enough of space to stretch out my feet underneath the driver's seat. As for legroom, I get about this much. And I get about this much in terms of headroom. The seats do feel really nice and comfortable because they are finished in Nepal leather. So it gives you a really nice extra level of comfort. And you do sit upright because this being an SUV and it's really high, so it gives you a lot of headroom. It feels really nice, and I can assure you that adults would be comfortable for long distance journeys. So you have a seat storage in this nice leather pouch for both sides. There are cutouts for the front seats which aid in legroom. You have B-pillar aircon vents as well. And right here, as mentioned just now, you have your 4-zone automatic climate control system. All of the controls are located right here. You have your right passenger temperature, fan speed, and different modes. And your left passenger's temperature, fan speed, and different modes. The central locking is for the back as well. Electronic central locking for the rear. Grab handle and coat hook for both sides. Rear interior lights can be used as reading lights as well. For both sides as well, once again. Coat hook for both sides. Very decent front center armrest with two cup holders. The interior just looks amazing. Fuel door. This Porsche Cayenne S is not equipped with the powered tailgate, so to open up the rear hatch, there's only one way, which is just walk up towards the rear hatch itself, locate a touchpad below the Cayenne S lettering, and then just press on it. It will open right up. Boot space in the Porsche Cayenne S is quite good. Below this floor, you have a storage area below. Your hooks right here, both sides. Get a power outlet as well right here. Speaker back here as well. Your rear tonneau cover. You can remove this tonneau cover as well. You get your rear boot lights as well, on both sides. Very nice cuff plates as well right here. As for headrests, the front headrests are adjusted using the button right here. And for the rear, it's the same way, adjusted using the button right here. Speaker right here and up here, bottle holder, storage, puddle light right here, window control, storage area right here, same set of piano black material right here, central locking, 3% memory setting for the fully powered passenger seat. All of the controls are located right here, and it is the same set of controls as the driver. All of the controls are right here, together with your 4-way power lumbar support and your powered thigh support right here. Cayenne S dorsals. It gets the same seat upholstery as well in black Nepal leather. Sun visor for the passenger side. Just get a vanity mirror and a light, and it gets the extendable shade as well, so you can put this on this side and then you have another extra shade right here. Nicely sized lockable glove box, and the passenger does get a grab handle. As you can see, this is the reverse camera for the Porsche Cayenne S. It looks quite clear as well. It's not the best either, but it looks okay nonetheless. It looks alright if you ask me. It has the guidance lines right there. It looks nice. So now let's start the car with the door closed. So that's all for today's video of the 2013 Porsche Cayenne S. Thanks for watching and goodbye.